In this part of the tutorial, we'll be going over embedding multimedia content, pop-ups, and using the MagPlus feature builder to link to HTML content. If we want to include multimedia content, such as a YouTube or Vimeo video, it's best to just link to it. This way, if the user who uploaded the video to YouTube disables the option for embedding, our users won't be affected. However, if using our own footage, we can include the video in our assets folder and embed it straight into the app. The plus side of doing this is that our users no longer have to have internet access to view our video. The downside is that depending on video length and quality, it can drastically increase our file download size. One way that tablet designers are really using embedded videos creatively is on publication covers. To demonstrate this, we'll be using a couple of different videos I created using After Effects. First, let's look at our new InDesign document, which is appropriately named Cover. For our cover video to extend full screen in both orientations, we'll need to make sure the video is at least 1024 by 1024 pixels, or higher for the Retina version. We'll place a still frame of the video on the B background layer so that an image appears in the scrubber of the iPad app. After making sure it's on the correct layer, we'll then click Add Movie. Once again, we'll leave these fields untouched. We'll choose Inline Movie, Source Type File, and then direct it to the file URL. We'll select Auto Start since it's the cover, and unselect Hide Media at End. We can see that this green transparent box appeared over our page. This is the area that the media will be displayed in. In this instance, we'll keep it as it is. It also automatically added a blue clickable area. If we wanted to confine the clickable area to a small play button, we could resize this blue transparent frame. Let's fast review our design. So we can see that our cover works both in portrait and in landscape. Now say that we want to add cell lines and other design elements to our cover. We'll go back to our layers palette, and we can hide media and clickable areas temporarily. And we're going to place these on the B slides pen blocks. We'll make the box logo pen right top, the cover title pen left, and the cell line pen left bottom. And we'll fast review our design. So there's lots of opportunity to do some really cool stuff. We can also have video pop up or play full screen. It doesn't always have to play in line. Here's a quick example. On this page, we can add a different video clip. We'll select our content, add movie, but this time, let's set it to pop up. We'll direct to our movie, readjust our media play area, and finally, we'll readjust the clickable area. Now we can fast review. We could also select full screen, and then we wouldn't need to set the size of our media area. You can also embed solely audio, too. There are a few more options with embedding video, which are explained in more detail in this awesome video by Mike on the MagPlus site. Let's move on to pop-ups. A pop-up is just what it sounds like. The user clicks on an object and a larger version of an object appears. Say we were designing an article that was reviewing a sushi restaurant and wanted a large detail shot of the food, but faced layout constraints. This would be a good use of the pop-up feature. Pop-ups can exist on both the A, B, and B, pin layers, so it's a pretty flexible feature. To add a pop-up, we'll make sure our image is on the B pin blocks layer. Then we'll click Add Link. We'll see that the blue clickable area was automatically added. If we go back to the Mag Plus object palette, we can change hotspot type or clickable type to pop-up. Now, we need to direct the clickable area to the URL of the larger pop-up object that we'll add in a minute. We can do this by entering pop-up colon /, and then choose any ID, preferably one that describes the picture or object, and type that ID name. We'll choose sushi. Then, we'll add our larger pop-up object on the corresponding layer. In our instance, this is the B pop-up's pin blocks. And we'll make it the size that we want it to appear on the device. Now we'll change the object type to pop-up and put the ID name we chose earlier, sushi, as the object ID. We have a few options for how we want to present it. Typically, I stick with modal. After fast reviewing it, we can see how the pop-up works in both orientations. Remember not to use the same object ID name twice because that'll cause conflicts. The final portion of the Part 3 tutorial will briefly cover the Mag Plus Feature Builder. We can access this by going to magplus.com, logging in with our user account, and going to My Mag Plus Feature Builder. Here we'll find multimedia features that are pretty straightforward and work right out of the box. Let's create a new photo slideshow to embed in our app. We'll click Images and give our project a name and description. I've already prepared my images in Photoshop, so I'll type in the dimensions. Now we can select from a variety of projects. Let's choose Slideshow with Swipe. We'll select it and then press Next. We'll upload our images similar to how we'd add photos on Picasa or Flickr. We should see our 5 images now. We can rearrange the order they appear in by clicking and dragging them around. We can also add or delete or crop our images. To add a caption and photo credit, we'll click the T and copy and paste our caption in. To preview our slideshow, we can either click Preview, or if you're collaborating with someone, you can send them this URL as long as they're logged into their account. We can click and drag to imitate the swipe feature. Also, if we click Info, our photo caption credit appears. We can tap to turn it off again. We can customize some of our UI elements, such as how the photo caption appears, by going back to our Feature Builder project and making sure Settings is clicked. Here we can change our background color, theme, swipe icon, or even the snap speed of the slideshow. Now we're ready to export our slideshow and embed it into our vertical. We'll click Export to download it. We should see a zip file of our slideshow, so we'll unzip it. And by default, the software names it Build. To keep things organized, we'll rename this slideshow. And we'll treat it like we would any other link and place it within our Assets folder. Back in our InDesign file, we'll place a placeholder image for our slideshow. This way, a preview of the vertical will appear in the scrubber. Then we'll go back to our Mag Plus object palette and change the object type to HTML. Finally, we'll direct it to our index.html file. Now we're ready to fast review our design. Our slideshow is fully swipeable. Our captions appear, and it works in both portrait and landscape. The coolest part about embedding HTML is that it's not just limited to the MagPost feature builder. If you know how to code or someone on your team does front-end development, you can essentially embed any markup, jQuery, CSS, etc. Here's a pretty extreme example I built to demonstrate querying multiple social media RSS feeds using some open source files found on GitHub. Notice that HTML blocks can also be pinned objects. If we look at our build, we'll see 5 different HTML files, a couple of CSS files, and our JavaScript. And yes, the MagPost plugin even supports HTML5. One word of advice, it seems really odd, but style your markup in millimeters and your type size in either ims or points. InDesign doesn't handle pixels very well, and this will save you a lot of troubleshooting. There's still some styling issues with this demo, but you get the point. Now that we have a few verticals to work with, let's export them to the production tool.